Hello children, how are you all today? I hope you all are healthy and happy. For today's English lesson, we are going to continue with the third chapter from your Honeycomb book. And this chapter, we have already finished two video lessons of it. You know it, in the first video lessons, we have done the explanation of the text. In the second part, we had finished the meanings and we had started working with the text. We had finished question number 1, 2 and 3, and for today's video lesson we will be continuing with the rest of the questions that follows. Okay children, if you haven't finished your meanings, you can go and watch the second part of this chapter and you can find the meanings right there. So children, let's move ahead. Let's write down the question answers from 4 onwards. Okay, how did Gopal get inside the palace to see the king after he had bought the fish? So now we know that he bought the fish. Now we will see how did he reach inside the king's palace. Okay, when Gopal reached the palace, number 4. So this children is on page number 42 only, working with the text. This is a continuation from your previous video lesson. This is a continuation, so I'm writing cont. Now number 4, answer number 4. When Gopal reached the palace, he told the guards that he wanted to meet the king. But the guards stopped him from going inside. Gopal began to sing and dance . We children sing loudly and dance . The king heard the noise and ordered the guard to bring him in. Right children, this is your fourth answer. When Gopal reached the palace, he told the guards that he wanted to meet the king, but the guards stopped him from going inside. Gopal began to sing loudly and dance. The king heard the noise and ordered the guard to bring him in. Okay children, so this here we are done with fourth answer. Now moving to the fifth question. explain why no one seemed to be interested in talking about the Hilsa fish which Gopal had bought. Okay, now let's read it. Let's write the answer. Number 5. No one seemed interested in talking about the Hilsa fish. That Gopal had bought because they were more surprised prized with his appearance half shaved face ash smeared on the body and rags instead of proper clothes. Yes, children, this made them wonder what had happened to him. Okay, children, so number 5, no one seemed interested in talking about the Hilsa fish that Gopal had bought because they were more surprised with his appearance. What appearance? Half-shaved face, ash smeared on the body and rags instead of proper clothes. This made them wonder what had happened to him. Okay. Children, so with this we have completed the question answer. Now we have true and false that follows. Let's see. The king lost his temper easily. Yes, do you remember that the king said, sorry, I lost my temper? Yes, because he was so angry with all of them talking about Hilsa fish that made him lose his temper. So yes, this is true. I will be writing the answers. You have to write the question. So this is number 6. First one is true. Number 2. What is the second question? Let's read it. Gopal was a madman. No, he was very intelligent, very clever. So 2 is false. Number 3. Gopal was a clever man. Yes, he was a clever man. True. Number 4. Gopal was too poor to afford decent clothes for all because he was one of the most important courtiers in the king's court, so he could not be poor. He could afford clothes, but you know why he was dressed in rags, right? So this will be false. And the last is number 5. Let's see what is its answer. The king got angry when he was shown to be wrong. No, king appreciated the witty man Gopal, right? The wit of Gopal or the wittiness of Gopal. So he was not at all angry. So this is false. Okay, children, so we are done with the working with the text. Now we will be moving to working with language. This is also starting from page number 42 only, and it is continuing till page 43. So children, here you will see that, you know, speech bubble. We have read in a comic book. In a comic book, you will notice that there are speech bubbles. Now, what are speech bubbles, children? You will see that in the comment, wherever the characters are speaking, you will see there's something round like thing, and an arrow pointed kind of opening is given to that speech bubble. Whenever characters speak or they give some speech, the speech bubble appears. So you know this is an important feature of which type of books, which form of writing stories. It's present in comic. So comic books have these speech bubbles usually. So their children, what do we see? That when someone speaks, that is in their direct speech, they are saying it, so we can write that in speech bubble. But do you know when we inform to someone else about what the person has spoken, what do? We actually report. Okay, when you report what something has spoken, like your mother told you that you have to bring coffee. She said, my mother said, bring me coffee. Okay, so how can you report it? That my mother said that I should bring her a coffee, or I should bring her coffee. Okay, so like this, we report to some other people. This is called reported speech. Okay, we report, we tell it to some other person, we report it. So this is usually, you can see that news reporters, you have heard about them, journalists, they report news. They do not say it in direct speech. They report that they have heard this story from somewhere, and then now they are telling it to you, telling it to us through the media. So this is kind of reported speech. So children, we will see there are few questions. We will be doing this in your language, in your grammar. Okay, so if we get time, we will definitely touch this portion in your direct and indirect speech, in your narration. We will be doing that, don't worry. Now here you can see there are some questions that we have to change in reported speech, because all these sentences have appeared in the speech bubble in your chapter. So we will have to write all these speeches in the reported speech. So the first one is already done for you. Let's see what's the first one. How much did you pay for that, Hilsa? That was the question which the people, the villagers were asking. So how is it changed? Okay, the woman asks the man how much he had paid for the Hilsa. You can see how it's changed. We are reporting that who asked whom? The woman asks the man how much he had paid for the Hilsa. So children, you should remember that when we are reporting, especially in questions, when there is a question in the direct speech, then we don't use that, the word that we don't use to change it into indirect speech. Okay, we skip it. Instead, we use the question word. Like you can see in the question, how much did you pay for that Hilsa? That how word has to be used in place of which word? That. So that's why, this is the reason, in this answer you won't find any that, because we have changed question direct speech into indirect speech. You should note this. The woman asked the man how much he had paid for the Hilsa. Now second one, children, is also a question. So let's see that. Why is your face half shaven. This is a question. You know what we have to do. Why is the word there? So we are not going to use that. We are not going to write like this. Gopal's wife asked him that his face was half shaven. No, we are not going to use the word that, but we are instead going to use the word question word that is there. So let us write down the answer quickly. Gopal's wife. This is working with the language. Now we are starting to work with the language. Working with the language. Number one is already given, so we will be doing from two onwards. Why is your face half shaven? Gopal's wife. Because we know who asked this. Gopal's wife asked this, so we will be writing Gopal's wife asked him why his face. Now children, see why we have written, after why we have written the subject, his face was shaven. The verb comes at the end. In the reported speech, we can see we have written this way. So, him, why his face was half shaven, actually not only shaven, so half shaven here. Now, let's move to number three. Let's see what is the question. I accept the challenge, Your Majesty. So, this is a statement. We are not going to use why, how, what, because this is not a question. We are instead going to use that. I will show you where I am asking you to use that. Okay. So, Gopal told the king. He is not asking here, so we won't use the word ask. He tells him. So, Gopal told him. The past tense of tell is Gopal told the king. That he... accepted his challenge. So children, you should also remember that, see, I have used the word that here. You should also remember that in the direct speech there can be any tense, especially present tense can be used a lot of times, even past tense. There are certain rules how you are going to change it into indirect speech. So here, because it was present tense, challenge, accept, so we have changed it into past tense, accepted. Okay children, so now moving to the next one, number four. I want to see the king. Number four. I want to see the king. Gopal told the guards, because we know he told it to the guards. Gopal told the guards that he wanted to see the king. Now number five children. Bring the man to me at once. This is the last one for this direct indirect speech, reported speech. The king, now we can see that is an imperative sentence. What did I tell you about imperative sentences? That it can be orders, that means commands or suggestion or advice. Here this is a command, so ordered. We are going to use the verb ordered. The king ordered the guard to bring the man to him at once. At ones. Okay, children, so please write it down. This is not underlined, I just did this to make you understand. The king ordered the guard to bring the man to him at once. So I hope you are done with this, children. Now in the next part, page 43 only, you can see that there are certain words which we have to write the meanings, and then we have to write a sentence using that word. So let us do that. Some words we have already written in meaning, still we are going to write it here as well because it has been asked to do so. So let's start. Find out the meanings of these words and you have to make a sentence or frame a sentence. Children, you can write the sentence on your own, but still, because we have to do the lesson completely, I am writing it down for you. So this is on page number 43 now. We have done two. Two was that speech bubble thing, reported speech. And now we are doing the meanings. Find out the meanings. First word we have, the second one. First word we have, challenge. Challenge means what, children? Challenge means to dare. To give someone dare. Okay. You can write any sentence. Let me write like this. I am writing a sentence using the word challenge. I can frame a sentence like the man challenged. So children, this is the present tense. I am using the past tense. You can definitely change the tense of the word in your sentence. The man challenged his friend. So now let's underline challenge, because we have been asked to use this word in our sentence. Now number two, second one is mystic. Mystic. You can either write what I have made you write in the meanings portion, or you can write this one also. Believing in spiritual. Believing in spiritual power. So let us write a simple sentence. He is a mystic man, one who believes in spiritual power or have some magic power, spiritual divine knowledge. Mystic man. Okay, children, let us underline this one, mystic. Okay, now moving to the next word, third. We have written this word also in your meanings part. Comical. Comical means what? Funny, cartoon-like. We have written the meaning there as well in the meanings. Funny, cartoon-like. Or hilarious, whatever. There can be a lot of synonyms. You can use them. So I liked the comical act. I liked the comical act of the Joker. Okay, children. So now number four. Let me change the color of the pen because this is getting lighter. Number four. Hootier. Official of the king's court. Official of the king's court. Okay, children, so this is till 4. Now, number 5, smearing. Okay, I did not write the sentence for it. Let me write down the sentence first. So, Tenali Raman was one of the wittiest courtiers of Krishna Deva Raya's court. Okay, children. So here it is. Underline this one, comical. Then here we are going to underline. Tenali Raman was one of the wittiest courtiers. So here you are going to underline courtiers. Okay, children. Yes. So now moving to number 5. Smearing. I hope you are done with this one, children. Now let's move to number 5. Smearing. This also we have written in the meaning section. Spread over the surface. Right, what we can write about it? Let's take it from the text only, from the story only. His face was smeared with ash. Okay, children. So here, smeared, word, the past tense. This is ing verb. This is the past tense of smear. So we are done with this one also. Now, children, on page number 44, you will see there's a picture reading, right? There's a story about a stag. Stag is just like a deer. It's a breed, means it's just a different breed, but it's just like a deer in the appearance, but it has very beautiful antlers. Antlers are their horns. Okay, so we will be reading this story and we will be solving some question answers that are on page number 46 after 2 pages. Children, you can see that in this story there is picture. Okay, there are pictures. So sometimes what you might be asked to do, that you have to read the pictures, you have to narrate the story by learning about the picture. Okay, you will have to look at the picture carefully and you will have to make up a story after looking at the pictures carefully. So children, this is called picture story writing or story writing, by looking at those pictures. So children, let's see what has been talked about the stag. But I think we might do this one in our next video lesson, because yes, we will be starting it and we will just be able to complete only 2 to 3 questions, and then we have to again take it forward, carry it forward to the next video lesson. It's better to start this one in our next video lesson only. So children, thank you for watching the video. I hope you revise the lesson. I hope you quickly finish your lesson and you just finish your notebooks, write down the question answers and come to me in the online classes with preparedness, so that you can ask me your doubts, so that I can clear your doubts and we can discuss more about the elements in this story, right children? So please don't keep it on hold. Just finish writing, just complete your lessons. Till then, till our next video lesson, be healthy, keep yourself healthy, take care of yourself and your family. Bye-bye.